for candidate Wilson.
Same question?
No, we want to ask a different question. Because the school board does not have the authority to raise taxes itself, describe how you think the city council and taxing authorities should make decisions about revenue and think about results and outcomes from the school system.
Well, let me clarify a little bit. The school board does have the authority to raise the millage rate. So that means that we can add on to the millage that then determines your property tax for that year, and then that revenue is how we're funded. That is the only way school systems are funded, is through property tax. We do have something called the Education Special Local Option Sales Tax, ESLOS, as many of you know. Those types of votes, which thankfully you just passed, will help us build the new high school. Those types of revenue generators for us are only for capital improvements, so buildings, buses, textbooks, computers, things like that. Our actual day-to-day running payroll, which is our largest expenditure, is only through property tax. So let me make sure I understand the second part of that question. What would we do as a school board to work with the city council as far as tax? The only thing that we have experienced thus far with the city council has been, and we've been mutually affected, has been the change that the state made to gas tax, and that's been out of their control as well. So there haven't been many things that we have had to work in conjunction with them. Now, certainly do we enjoy the revenue we receive? Absolutely. But we have felt as school board, and we have not raised the millage, let me reiterate that, we have not raised the millage. We have actually decreased the millage when the property tax, your property was valued and it increased, and so we lowered the millage in order to keep it from giving us too much of an increase on your back. Does that make sense? I'm hoping I'm explaining that correctly. But again, you probably won't ever hear a political candidate say that, but money's not the issue. Parent involvement is the issue. And I'm jumping on topic, but we are our own worst enemies. We have got to work together to educate the children about Austin. That's parent and school and city. Thank you.